Hi everyone, welcome back to Probiotic series with me, Shikin. Now you're watching episode 4. In this episode, we will share with you on how to choose your probiotic. Stay tuned! If you search for probiotic product, you can find variety bacteria strain with different concentration. This bacteria concentration usually state as colony forming unit or CFU. Low CFU in the product might make the probiotic effect slower than expected. However, overdosage of the probiotic can cause immunosuppression due to the continuous response of non-specific immune system. Minimum CFU in the probiotic is 10 to the power of 5. Maximum are until 10 to the power of 9. However, the CFU number would differ according to the feed or water application. Probiotics are marketed in two forms, dry packet or liquid form. The dry probiotic that come in packet can be given with feed or applied to water and have to be brewed at pump site before application. Some dry product also does not need aeration of the probiotic before application. The hatcheries generally use liquid form, which are light and ready to add. These liquid form are directly added to hatchery tank or blended with pump heat. Liquid form give positive results in lesser time when compared to the dry and spore form bacteria, although they are lower in density. Probiotics are susceptible to high temperature. When exposed to any high temperature environment or process, it can reduce the viability and stability of the bacteria. So we need to take note on the storage method to make sure the probiotic achieve their shelf life. Aside from temperature, right pH is also important. The manufacturer might have produced the probiotic in a good pH and temperature, but it all comes to us on how we store the product so that the bacteria media does not contaminate and disturb. Probiotics are available in the market for various purposes. In the aquaculture, some probiotics focus on disease treatment, water quality and growth of the animal. As a farmer, we need to understand what is the suitable probiotic to encounter our current concern at the farm. Example, you have a water quality issue, but the probiotic that you purchase mainly functions to improve the gut health of the shrimp. How expensive or how good is your probiotic does not mean anything if you are not going for the right bacteria. You might want to seek advice first from the seller before making any decision. Advanced technology also helps the probiotic to be better to help the farmer. There are already probiotics that have multi-action in one product, meaning one probiotic product can do multiple treatment for your water or for the shrimp. Not every farmer need to use probiotic in their farm. If you didn't have any issue with the shrimp or water, you can exclude the use of the probiotic. For the shrimp farm, feed is the most expensive cost, which can account for 60% of the operational cost. If you see your feed conversion ratio or FCR is going good without probiotic, you can probably save a lot on the treatment cost. We have reached at the end of this episode. In the next episode, we will share with you on how to do assessment of your probiotic. So don't forget to give us likes and subscribe to get notification on the next episode. Bye, thank you for watching.